And now we're going to head north, possibly by dog sled, through some very rugged country to our newest state, where they conduct most of their business in the saloon. So let's take a seat down at the end of the bar and see what happens.
Grim and cold, he was bad and bold, he was dangerous than McGrew. While dangerous Dan was a play in his hand,
not how you play your hand,
and keeping his mind on his game, you could see standing by with a gleam in her eye and her hair just as red as a flame. A gal who was tall with a face like a doll and her fingernails painted. She was slender and tall, with a face like a doll. She was a lady that's known as Blue. When out of the night that was 50 below, and into the din and the glare, a man staggered in who was haggard and thin, and his face was filled with despair. He looked all around until he had found the lady that's known as Blue. Then the stranger turned, and his eyes, they burned. Ah! On dangerous and the groove.
And then suddenly there, all the lights went out, and the voice cried, "Die, you must."
No, no, no.
Then a shot rang out, and a woman screamed.
Somebody bit the dust. Then the lights flashed on, and the Northwest Mounted Police came a-crashing through dee doo doo. For they drew their guns and they said,
"Which one?
It is dangerous than McGrew."
And then somebody said,
"Well, hi there."
And skipped across the floor with a 1-2 skip and a hand on each hip.
And your own hip.
Right out through the open door. Now it wasn't the stranger taking his leave or the lady that's known as Lou. It was nobody else in the whole wide world but Dangerous Dan.
He's awful dangerous, all right.
Stick him up! This is a holdup. I'm going to rob all the women and kiss all the men.
Don't you mean you want to kiss all the women and rob all the men?
Listen, Todd, it's his robbery.
Oh, for heaven's sake!
Dangerous Dan! Dangerous Dan, he was a big bad man.
Enough of that rough life in the Northwest.